हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम प्रोफेसर कविता किशन रकाटी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एसपीएस कॉलेज ऑफ एजुकेशन संगम ने। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द टॉपिक ऑफ पीरियोडिक टेबल। फर्स्टली वी विल सी द पीरियोडिक टेबल, हाउ इट लुक्स लाइक। सी, दिस इज द पीरियोडिक टेबल। इन दिस पीरियोडिक टेबल देर आर 1 to 8, 7, एंड दिस 8 देर आर द पीरियड्स, एंड 1 to 18 देर आर द ग्रुप्स। दिस फर्स्ट एंड सेकेंड आर द एस ब्लॉक एलिमेंट्स, अल्कली एंड अल्कलाइन अर्थ मेटल्स आर देर। They are the D block elements, middle 3 to 12, and then from this 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. These are the P block elements, and in these gray color showing these are the metalloids, this green color showing these are the non-metals. This color fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and nitrogen, these are the halogen family elements, these are the also non-metals, and these are the helium, neon, these are the inert gases. They are inert gases, they do not take part in any chemical reaction. Helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon, these are the inert gases. Below this periodic table, these are the two series of lanthanides and actinides. These are the F block elements. From lanthanum 57 to lutetium 71, this is the lanthanide. And from these actinides, from this actinoid and up to this 103 element, these are the actinides. The properties of elements are a periodic function of their atomic number. As we see in the earlier slide, the atomic number is increases, and that's why according to this periodic table the elements are arranged. Structure of the modern periodic table. The modern periodic table, as we see in earlier slide, it contains 1 to 7 periods are there, that is the horizontal rows, and similarly the 18 vertical columns in this table are grouped 1 to 18 that I have shown in the earlier slide. Just see this first slide, second one slide. In this slide, see these 1 to 7, these are the horizontal rows, these are the periods, and 1 to these 18, these are the vertical columns, these are the what we call these periods, these are the groups. These properties of elements are a periodic function of their atomic numbers. As you seen in the earlier slide, in slide number 2, these properties of periodic elements are increasing atomic numbers. The classification of elements resulting from the arrangement of elements in increasing order of their atomic numbers, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, these are the atomic numbers. See, these are the 1, 3, 4, 2, 5, 6, these are the atomic numbers of the periodic elements. These are arranged in the increasing order of the atomic number. Then we will see the next slide, the structure of modern periodic table. As we see, structure of modern periodic table contains 7 periods and 18 groups are there. The next one, periodic table information. This entire periodic table is divided into 4 blocks, S, P, T and F. S block contains 1 and 2 groups, and group 3 to 12 consists of D block. Group 13 to 18 consists of a P block, and the lanthanide and actinide series are at the bottom of the periodic table, that is from F block. This is slide number 5 that I am showing to you. And this is the slide number 2, where the as we discussed in this slide, there are 4 block, S, P, D, F. S block contain 1 to 2 group, and D block contain 3 to 12 group, and P block contain 13 to 18 group. See in this slide, 1 to 2 groups are their vertical column, S block, 3 to 12 groups, there are the D block, 13 to 18, there are the vertical column groups, there are the P block, and lastly these are the F block elements are there. This is the periodic table information. Then next, see elements beyond the 92. 92 is the uranium is a 92. Uranium has atomic number 92. All the elements beyond the uranium with atomic number 93 to 118 are the man-made elements, and these are all these elements are radioactive and unstable and have a very short life. Means 92 elements are found in nature. See, this is up to this 92. This see this 92. These 92 up to 92 elements, these are formed in nature, and beyond the 92 up to 118, these 104 to 118, and from 93 to this up to 103, these all the elements are man-made elements. They have short, very short life. Next slide, we will see metals. What is the metals? Metals have a luster, that is a shiny appearance, conduct heat and electricity, can be drawn into a wire. Conduct heat and electricity means these metals are consider like gold, then copper. They are the metals. Can be gold. Can be drawn into wire or ductile. For example, gold. We can make a wire from the gold. Can be hammered into a thin sheets like aluminium. These metals can be hammered into thin sheets. See the examples: gold, silver, copper, iron, mercury is a liquid at room temperature. Mercury is a liquid at room temperature. It is a mercury is used in the thermometer in the chemical laboratory, physical laboratory. And all these are the elements have luster. They conduct electricity and heat. See, these are the metals. Let's see, we will see the metals in this periodic table. See, these are the platinum, mercury, gold. Then these elements are there. Copper. Copper is there. Nickel. These elements, rhodium, palladium, silver, cadmium, these are the metals. And these metals show this the property that I have shown you. These metals have a luster, shiny appearance. We see the gold, silver, even copper has iron as also. These are the shiny appearance. Then so we will see the next slide. These are the non-metals. These non-metals have no luster. Exception diamond and iodine. Diamond is a allotropes of a carbon non-metal. These are the exceptions. The diamond has a very shiny appearance. They are poor conductor of heat and electricity. Exception graphite. Graphite is also allotrope of carbon. These graphite's electrodes, that is carbon electrode graphite rod, are used in the battery and all these things. These conduct the heat and electricity. These non-metals have one more property, that is they cannot hammered into sheets or drawn into wire because they are brittle. For example, iodine, nitrogen, carbon. Then see the next set of metals. Some metals, metalloids. Now we will see the metals in this periodic table. See non-metals in this way. See the carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, phosphorus, sulfur. These are the non-metals. The fluorine. These are the non-metals. See the carbon is non-metal. Still the allotrope of the carbon, diamond and graphite. These are having the shiny appearance. Then we will see the metalloids. Metalloids have some elements have property of intermediate between the metals and non-metals. These are called metalloids or semi-metals. For example, include arsenic, silicon and germanium. Silicon is a semiconductor. Metalloids which are used in the solar cells. Arsenic is also used in some medicals also, medicines also. Compounds are the pure substances. Compounds, these are the elements different from the elements. They are the pure substances. Now we will see the next slide. Blockwise characteristic of elements. Characteristic of S block element. What is the S block element? S block contains the elements of the alkali group 1 and 2. Alkali metals and alkaline earth metals. They are the S block elements. First we will see the position of this S block element. See, this is the position of S block element. Element vertical column 1 and 2. These are the S block elements. These are the alkali earth metals. Lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, francium. They are the alkaline earth metals, beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium and radium. These S block elements have the properties like this. All these elements are reactive metal, occur in nature only in combined state. These compounds, exception lithium and barium, predominantly ionic. This is because of they have only one or two valence electrons, means lithium plus 1, beryllium plus 2, M plus or M2 plus ions. They have low ionization enthalpy, which decreases down the group. Then see, we will see the next slide of the characteristic of P block elements. From where the P block elements would see, firstly see the position of this P block elements. See, this is the in slide number 2, we can see the position of the P block elements. The P block elements are nothing but the group number 13 to 18. These are the P block elements: boron, aluminium, gallium, indium, then carbon, silicon, germanium, strontium, lead, nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, then antimony, bismuth, oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium, polonium, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, astatine, and these are the P block elements. And these in this P block elements, you will see the characteristics of these P block elements. These P block elements are the elements with the S block elements are mainly in P block elements. The P block elements, namely 18th group, there is the family of noble element gases, as we see helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. Then halogen family elements, 17 groups are there: fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, astatine. Group 16, chalogens include these radioactive non-metals, Then p block element also contains the three traditional types of elements: metals on the left, non-metals on the right, and the metal layers we separate for metal and non-metal. The non-metal characteristic increases as we move from the left to the right, whereas it decreases. Non-metal character increases from left to right. See the what we see the p block element contains three traditional elements: metal on the left hand side, non-metal on the right hand sides. We will see this in the periodic table. See this p block element in this periodic table. Metals are on the left hand side. This side, these are the metals. C. This right hand side, these are the non-metals. And between these, they are the metalloids. There are three traditional type of p. These are the p block elements. And then we will see the f block element. F block elements are the last electron is filled in f orbital, as there are seven orbitals in the f subshell, and these are the f block elements constitute the 14 elements lanthanide and actinide. They are placed separately in this periodic table. So thank you very much.